We need a new era of climate diplomacy, one where climate risks are integrated into foreign policy agendas.
Whether it's terrorism, whether it's climate change, transboundary rivers, desertification, none of these abide by arbitrary administrative borders. That's where diplomacy needs to help. That's where the defense community needs to help, because nation states can't solve this alone.
It's very important to address climate security risks as part of instability and fragility considerations globally today, because we are seeing increasing floods, droughts, extreme weather events, migration of people across borders, as well as sea level rise, and we're going to see increasing challenges globally. In diplomacy, we need to understand how this is changing, how we interact with countries. We need to address these risks at the highest diplomatic level. Following on from a successful agreement in Paris, we need to integrate these into our diplomatic practices worldwide.
Climate diplomacy is what changes the perception of national interests, which then causes countries to give their negotiators different instructions, which means we get better deals.
There are different entry points and approaches to climate diplomacy. Reaching out to the public and to governments is just as important as it is to engage in conflict prevention and peace building. Diplomacy has to use its entire toolbox to address the various impacts of climate change.
In foreign policy, foreign ministers can do a lot. And you know, it's oftentimes very easy to think that, well, all of these have very specific technological solutions, and as long as we do those things, we can address these issues. And that's true, there are technological solutions. But if we're not, as we say in the United States, putting this issue in the big kids table versus the little kids table, then that includes in our foreign ministries and in our defense ministries, in national security councils in places like the United States and elsewhere. If it's not at that level, and it's just being treated as a sort of this little environmental issue that, you know, the environment ministers will take care of, then we'll never solve the problem.
There's environmental policies to fight against environmental degradation. There's developmental policies to deal with the situations of environmental degradation caused by climate change. Then we have the classic diplomatic tools. When there's a crisis that's already at hand, a loss of stability, mediation, peace building, all that needs to consider climate aspects. So if you build a peace in a way that doesn't consider climate results, your peace building may not be stable either.
So as long as you can promote dialogue and have a fora whereby these challenges can be discussed, which is the role of diplomacy, if that can be institutionalized, then there is a scope to address these problems in a far better way than if these foras do not exist.
It's not just climate change, it's ecosystem degradation more in general. It's a mix that combines with exclusion of people, it's human rights violations, and all of that combines into a toxic cocktail. What that toxic cocktail has, where the Foreign Office can help, is that it does not respect any nation states.
We need a new climate diplomacy to manage geopolitical changes proactively, an era where diplomats make climate change a political priority. An era of cooperation between diplomats and other branches and levels of government, between governments and businesses, and between countries and regions. An era of a new climate for peace. To learn more about this topic, and to find recommendations for policymakers, have a look here.